Greetings from the Redeemed Christian Church of God in Oklahoma City. This is the Open Heavens for December 17th, 2019. Open Heavens is a daily devotional written by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. The title for today is The Principles of Success. Principles of Success. And I pray that even as we go into the study of His Word today, that based on what we study, the Lord God Almighty shall make us successful people indeed, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The memory verse is Proverbs 24, verse 3. Proverbs 24 verse 3 reads, "Through wisdom is an house builded, and by understanding it is established." Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6 to verse 11 is the Bible reading. Proverbs 6, 6 to 11 reads, "Go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider our ways and be wise. Which, having no captain, overseer, or ruler, provides our supplies in the summer and gathers our food in the harvest. How long will you slumber, O sluggard? When will you rise from your sleep? A little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to sleep. So shall your poverty come on you like a prowler, and your need like an armed man." God bless the reading of His holy word in Jesus' name. Amen. So we are talking about the principles of success today. And our Dad in the Lord is teaching us these principles from different angles. Now, one of the first principle that has been looked at in the devotional of today for success is, and it has to do with, knowledge. Knowledge. And knowledge, we can consider as to be powerful, because it's a major factor that controls our decision-making process. The knowledge of what we know or what we don't know, more often than not, determines how we make decisions. And of course, decisions that we make ultimately determine the course of our lives. So we can see that knowledge determines the course of our lives based on the decisions we make, by the knowledge that we have or we don't have. And if one tries to despise knowledge, what happens? There's perishing. Even that's what we have in Hosea 4:6, that my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Now, in line with that, we can also talk about wisdom, because these are principles that are needed for us to succeed. Now, the wisdom we need to take crucial decisions, how do we find it as believers? Where can we get that wisdom from? Well, it is from the written and spoken word of God. For the written word of God, of course, through the Bible, through His written word, we can get wisdom for right decisions. Also, even from the spoken word, he can choose to speak through the Bible or even through prophetic utterances of genuine, that's very important, genuine men and women of God. And that is asking us a question that is meant to ask us and see our readiness to be successful. What is that question? Because we've already emphasized the fact that reading the word of God is important for us to be successful. So the question is, how much time do you set aside for studying the Bible? That is an indicator of how real we or how serious we are about being successful. And you know, that is encouraging us that we should not see personal Bible study as a waste of time. That, okay, maybe the unbelievers are not studying the Bible, or even some Christians don't study the Bible as much as you are doing. No, you should not be discouraged by that, because you might think that as you study the Word of God, even day and night, even at night, You are not losing time. You are not wasting time. You are actually gaining time. Because those who don't study the word of God, they will go into pitfalls. They will make errors. But because one has studied the word of God, what happens? One actually gains time because one has studied the word of God earlier and will avoid such errors and pitfalls of those who don't study the word of God. So the encouragement is that we should give the word of God priority in our lives. The word of God should be a priority in each and every of our lives as believers if we want to have the true success that comes from the Lord. You know, that is still mentioned about knowledge even towards the end of devotional again, about the fact that we should depend on godly knowledge for us to be successful rather than worldly knowledge. Because the truth of the matter is that the dependence on worldly knowledge will lead to failure. But when we depend on godly knowledge, what are we guaranteed? Success, which is in line with the study of today. And this biblical knowledge and godly knowledge we're talking about actually encompasses a lot of things, both scientific, philosophical, psychological, spiritual knowledge. They are all embedded even in this biblical knowledge we're talking about. But this biblical knowledge is superior to any other kind of knowledge. And that is why that's the main knowledge we need as believers, as it even encompasses every other kind of knowledge. And that is also mentioned something important for us here too, that yes, knowledge is important and it's integral. It's an integral principle for success. But it's not just about just knowing the word of God. But the most important part is doing the word of God. Doing the word of God is important for us to be successful. That's why even James 1:25 talks about it's not but a doer of the work. This man shall be blessed in his deed. Not just being a forgetful area, but a doer. So this knowledge has to be applied and done, put into practice for it to bring about knowledge. And that also briefly mentions two other areas about how principles of success for a believer. One is that there is wisdom in hard work, diligence. Just like even the story of the ants that they read in the Bible reading. We must be diligent and hardworking to be successful. Another thing is that we need to, what has been termed here, saving for the rainy day. And you know that is also using these two principles that some people can be hardworking, but they might not be saving because they are eating both their food and their seed. So it's good to be hardworking, but we should not eat our food and seed, especially as believers in the areas of tithing and offering. We should not say because we are successful, we should eat our food and seed. Rather, we need to save for the rainy day. And as we do that, what are we guaranteed of? God's covenant blessing. So if you want to be successful, then there's a place of wisdom, there's a place of knowledge, there's a place of hard work, there's a place of saving for the rainy day, that there's a place of putting to practice the knowledge that we have received in God's word. And as we do this, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. The prayer point is that, Father, please, Lord God Almighty, endow me with wisdom from your spirit illuminated word so that I may gain wisdom for a successful life. We pray, Lord Jesus, oh God, that, Lord, you will endow us with wisdom from your spirit illuminated word so that we may gain wisdom for a life of success in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, gracious Lord. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Amen. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you tomorrow by God's grace.